This is with respect to laparoscopic hernia surgery. When we are doing a laparoscopic surgery and we are trying to reduce the neck of the sac from the internal ring, this is the location of the internal ring, because we know that the testicular artery and the testicular vein is coming out and the ductus deferens is coming out. So this is the location of the internal ring as seen from inside. This is the opening of the internal ring in the fascia transversalis. We notice that the testicular artery, the testicular vein is running a little laterally, and then they are coming and joining with the femoral aorta and the inferior vena cava. The ductus deferens goes medially into the pelvis, and below we have the external iliac artery and the external iliac vein, which will go under the inguinal ligament. So this is the region where the surgeon, laparoscopic surgeon, has to operate to reduce the hernial sac in the internal ring. This is referred to as the triangle of doom, because there are so many important vascular structures which are here which may be injured. So this is the triangle of doom on the right side. Now let me show you the triangle of doom on the left side. The left side of the cadaver, to show you the same thing, this is the testicular vein and the testicular artery. The testicular vein, as we know, on the left side, it opens directly into the left renal vein, and this is the testicular artery. They are coming through the internal ring where my instrument is located. And medially is this ductus deferens. So when the laparoscopic surgeon is operating by means of laparoscopy and he's trying to reduce the indirect hernial sac through the internal ring, he will have to operate in this triangular region, medially bounded by the ductus deferens, laterally bounded by the testicular vessels, and external iliac artery and external iliac vein. So this is the triangle of doom on the left side. Now I would like to draw your attention to yet one more vessel, which is running on the inner surface of the rectus abdominis muscle. We can see an artery running in the posterior wall of the inguinal canal on the left side, and that is this artery here. This is the inferior epigastric artery. This inferior epigastric artery, it runs behind the fascia transversalis, and I have picked it up here. This is the inferior epigastric artery. It is located medial to the internal ring, and it runs on the posterior surface of the rectus abdominis muscle. So this is one artery, and also arising from the external iliac artery, we can see this artery here. This is the deep circumflex iliac artery, which runs along the inner surface of the iliac crest, and this anastomosis with this artery here and this artery here. This is the iliolumbar artery, which anastomosis with the L5 lumbar artery, iliolumbar artery, and the deep circumflex iliac artery, and they form an arterial anastomosis on this region. This is what is seen on the left side. Let us take a look at the same thing on the right side. So again, we are on the right side on the inguinal canal, and here we can see, let me just reflect this up to show you, this is the femoral artery, which is the continuation of the external iliac artery. And the femoral artery is giving rise to a superficial circumflex iliac artery, which we can see here. And further inside, we can see it is giving rise to this artery here, which is the deep inferior epigastric artery. And we can see the inferior epigastric artery is running on the posterior surface of the rectus abdominis. Inferior epigastric artery on both the sides is a very important landmark with respect to inguinal canal and inguinal hernia surgery, because the inferior epigastric artery is located just medial to the internal ring or the deep inguinal ring, and that is used as a landmark. Just lateral to that is the internal ring. Let's take a look at a branch from the external iliac artery, which I mentioned showed on the left side. This is that branch which I was talking about, and we can see clearly on this side it is arising from the external iliac artery. This is the deep circumflex iliac artery. This deep circumflex iliac artery runs on the inner surface of the iliac crest, and it anastomoses with the L5 artery coming from the lumbar aorta, and it forms an arterial anastomosis, and it also receives a communication from the iliolumbar artery, which is a branch from the posterior division of the internal iliac, the smallest posterior division. So this is another arterial anastomosis which happens on the inner side surface of the greater pelvis.
Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.